You're in for a wonderful, wonderful experience tonight, I promise you. And let me add something to what Bill just told you. The gentlemen who will be playing tonight represent the last generation of people who can in this country, and increasingly in Europe as well. So this makes it doubly special. I want to, in 25 words or less, tell you something about who we are and where we come from, because Hollywood has really done a number on our people. And while you may think you know what gypsies are, let's go back to square one, and I'll tell you our real history. And I'll start by telling you that Gypsy isn't even our real name. That's a name that was applied to us when our ancestors first arrived in Europe about 600-700 years ago, and were thought to be from Egypt. The word Gypsy comes from Egyptian. But we have no connection with Egypt whatsoever. In the past few years, a group of us who are Roma, who speak our language, and who have some training in history and linguistics and so on, have been re-examining our own history. And the picture that has emerged is, in very abbreviated form, as follows. From our language, it's quite clear that we were originally from India. For those of you who are interested in this, outside in the lobby there's a calendar, this year's calendar, with some of the words and a song, our national anthem, in our language, so you can see what it looks like. People have known that for well over 200 years. The European scholars recognize that pretty early. But who and what we were and when we left, that was much more of a puzzle. We know now that our ancestors were in fact a conglomeration of different ethnic peoples of Indian descent who were assembled to create a military force called the Rajputs, specifically to try and prevent the spread of Islam into the north of India. This is about 1,000 years ago. The Muslim troops under Muhammad of Ghazni ultimately won. They moved in, and the results of that are still creating problems today in Kashmir and elsewhere. Most of the Islamic incursions were victories, but a number of them were not. There were some victories on the Indian side, during which time the Muslims were pushed out of the north of India, and the Rajputs followed them. And when we look at Rajput history, we find that they too acknowledge that some of those Rajputs never came back, they just kept going. We look at the language, we look at the history, and so on. When we look at the language, we look at the words which are not Indian. Most of the language is Indian, but there are words in there, for example, from Persian. So we know that the migration must have gone through Persia. There are Armenian words. So the route must have gone through Armenian too, and so on. There are not Arabic words, there are not Turkish words, and in that way, we can plot the geographical route. By the time our ancestors reached the Byzantine Empire, which is today Turkey, and where Greek was spoken, the Muslims were also pushing towards the west. And some of the what can we call them, pre-Roma, which is the right word for gypsies, became military attachments. Obviously, they hadn't lost their military identity and had become military attachments to the Turkish, the Ottoman troops, and came up into Europe in that way. Others, however, were enslaved in the Balkans. So by the 1300s, we already had accounts from what is today Romania of the Roma being bought and sold as slaves. Not all of the first Roma were enslaved. We estimate about only half of the population was enslaved, and that situation lasted up until the 1850s and 1860s, when there was abolition. Our particular Roma were not enslaved. They are traced to the Austro-Hungarian Empire and are called by other groups of Roma Bashaldei, which means musician, gypsies. This is what we are best known for. I, unfortunately, can only play a phonograph, but my family was musicians. So the history of Roma incorporates slavery, and in particular, the Holocaust as well. The final solution was directed only at two groups identified by their ethnicity, race, the Jews and the Roma. And this is very much a part of our thought today. We are learning more all the time. We're filling in the details about the history of the persecution and what happened and what has happened since. Unfortunately, since 1945, things really haven't improved very much. And since the fall of communism, about 10 years ago, things have really declined for Roma, because we have no territory. We're not European. And in a Europe that's now fragmenting into nation states, Serbia for Serbs, Bosnia for Bosnians, Slovakia for Slovaks, and so on, we had nowhere to go. We're outsiders in everybody's country. And over the centuries, this kind of pressure, this being pushed from place to place, has made life very difficult, and it's made us draw into ourselves and to look for happiness wherever we can find it. And part of that happiness we draw from our ability to sing and express our feelings through music. And you will feel this when you listen to the music tonight. And so, let me say again, welcome and thank you for coming, and you're in for a wonderful, wonderful evening. Go.
Thank you, Dr. Hanka. I have to tell you, I have known Ian for almost 11 years, and the two of us have worked on many human rights projects in Europe. And I have to say that he's a remarkable man. He's done a lot for the Roma people. Well, right now, we'd like to bring to the stage Roma, Roma Bashade, which means the gypsies that play. Let's have a nice round of applause for the Roma.
Thank you.
wonderful? I'm very proud to tell you that all these members are my family. Yes, they are. Our music, we have kept in our family for centuries. What you're hearing, some of the music is centuries old. In fact, many of the great composers, like Franz Liszt, Brahms, they took our melodies and created the Hungarian dances, but they came from the Gypsies. It's the music of the Gypsies that you're hearing today. We're going to feature now, Alex, do you have a special? Or should we take a short intermission here? But these guys, they traveled a great distance to get here and not much sleep. We're going to take a short intermission. By the way, there is some refreshments. We have some punch, if you like, in the atrium there. And we'll be back in about 15 minutes.
The cymbalum actually was discovered in about 750 B.C. in Egypt. It was a much smaller instrument than this. They placed it on a table. It didn't have any pedals or anything. So what actually it is strings that are placed across a bridge and struck with two mallets. The cymbalum as it is 4.5 octaves, 2 octaves below middle C, 2.5 octaves above. And the music for it looks like piano music. It's written in 2 clefs, a treble clef and a bass clef. But the cymbalum, as you see it, this cymbalum comes from Budapest. And instruments are used in Budapest, in Romania, in Slovakia, and for a time they were used in Greece until the bouzouki came, and the bouzouki is now became a lead instrument. But most of the players that you'll find are in folk orchestras. That's where it's used as part of the folk ensembles. So we're going to continue with our program, and as a matter of fact, the first thing we're going to do is by Franz Liszt. It's a Charivach by Franz Liszt.
Thank you. before I begin, I had a request. People are very curious to find out what the words mean to the songs that we've been doing. Many of the gypsy songs are written with a passion of a loved one or a sadness, you know, something difficult that happened in their life. And in order for any of the musicians and any of the gypsies to deal with it, we deal with all of our passions with music. So the first song that I sang was a song of loss, how hurt my heart was. Paromanga, my heart hurts. And, you know, because their loved one left. The second one was a loss of the parents. And that song dates back, is a very old song, many centuries old. And it was especially sung by young children during the Holocaust, because most of the parents were gone and the children were left as orphans. And these next set of songs that we're going to be doing also deals with love. But this is a love of a person loving and leaving, which is the case in many of the songs that we do. The second song will be also of love, but this time the guy took off with the money. So, also a sad song. And many of the songs that have been played here by all of the musicians, they range from Romanian ethnic music, gypsy music, also Hungarian and Slavish or Slovak gypsy, which is where our origin is originally, where most of us are American born now, except for one of our musicians in the group. He's from Hungary. He's a very famous musician there. Excellent. We love him. But what we're going to do for you now is a couple of more sad songs, so enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
To that little one.
Wow.